Have you noticed when you go into Safe for Web to export your photos, the color shifts when they appear in there? Let me show you how to fix that. In a minute, I'll go deeper for the people that want to dig into the nitty-gritty. But for those who want to just know how to export and maintain the colors, let's jump into that first. So we're going to choose File, Export, Save for Web. All right, if you look at this, you can see the colors have definitely shifted. Now, I'm in the Optimize tab, which is what the image is going to look like after you've exported it. If we go to the original, we see it actually looks better. And if we turn off Convert to sRGB, this should be pretty close to the original image. So if you're in a monitor color right now and it looks really far apart, that's probably because you need to calibrate your monitor. All right, so let's jump in and look at the optimized. So this is what's going to look like afterwards. Even though we're in monitor color, it's very far off. Now, if we change this preview to document profile, it should look a little bit closer. Now, if we look here, it's still not perfect, but it's definitely a lot closer. I know I just calibrated my monitor, and before that, it was really far apart, so that calibration will help. Okay, so here's the good news. Even if this display looks like it's off a little bit, it's actually going to export with pretty close colors to what you see on your original. So let me just choose this right now. We're just going to choose Save, and I'll just drop this to my desktop. I'm going to drag it on top of the other image, and I'm going to hit Enter. Now, look at this. If I change the layers, look at that. It's exactly the same. So we didn't actually lose those colors when we exported it, even though it may have looked like we were losing a little bit in the Save for Web. Okay, there's another way for saving images that Adobe really wants us to use. Choose File, Export, and we can choose Export As. So this is a window that's supposed to take over Save for Web. Unfortunately, it doesn't have all the features, such as the ability to preserve all the metadata. Here we just have no metadata or copyright contact. But if we look at this, we can see, okay, that's not quite right either. See how the colors don't match? But if I turn off Convert to sRGB, so the colors here will now match the colors in my window. If they don't, it's because you need to calibrate your monitor. Now we're going to choose Convert to sRGB. When I do that, it looks a little bit different. But once again, once I export this file and I bring it in, it's going to match. In fact, why don't I prove that to you? So we're just going to choose Export. And we're going to drop it onto the desktop. And if I bring it into Photoshop, drop it on top. Hit Enter. Notice we've got a new layer on top, and yes, you can see no difference. So yes, that is matching the colors on that image because that's the image we just exported. All right, let's dig in a little bit deeper. So the first thing you want to do is figure out what profile you're going to be working in. In this case, I'm working in Adobe RGB. The reason for that is my monitor is 99% Adobe RGB. The monitor I'm using is a BenQ SW321C, which is a photographer monitor. I'll add a link to that. And when I'm not worried about print, I have a second monitor, which is one of the PD, which is the Professional Designer Series, which is a little less expensive. And the device I use to calibrate is a Calibrite Display Plus HL. Broken down to its most basic form, an ICC color profile or a color profile is a piece of data that's attached to your image and travels with it. It communicates with your hardware and software and tells it how to properly display those colors. So if we want to see what we have, choose the little arrow here, and then we're going to choose Document Profile. So we can see this is Adobe RGB. Now when we're in Photoshop, we can set our default. Choose Edit, Color Settings. I've got mine set to Adobe RGB because this is the workspace that I want to work with consistently. So every RGB image you open may not be Adobe RGB. So we can control that. So if we set the RGB to off, what it's going to do is it's just going to strip the color profile out of an image and just leave it as untagged. If you want to work in a color managed workflow, you don't want that. So we've got two options. One, preserve embedded profile, which means when you open an image, you can check down here and see what profile it is. Or We can choose to convert it to working profile, which means that every image you open, it says, hey, do you want to convert this to Adobe RGB? May not always be the best choice because you may not get the result. So why don't we set this to preserve profile, and then we can have a look in a moment and how we're going to convert it. So what happens if you have an image that is not Adobe RGB? So we can see this is in ProPhoto. What if we wanted this into Adobe RGB? Let me show you how not to do it and how to do it. If we go on to edit, we can change assign profile. Now, this is what happens though. If you choose assign profile and we change this to, say, the working RGB, notice it's going to change it. So you don't want to do that. What you want to do is choose edit, convert to profile. We'll turn the preview on. Notice now it says Adobe RGB. Click OK. And now we can change that profile without shifting the colors. So if the profile is now matching, your image's color will match when you combine them into different layers. So I hope you found this useful. Let me know in the comments underneath, just a quick one this week. And if you're new, welcome to the cafe. Hit the subscribe button, turn on notifications. You won't miss any of my tutorials. And until next time, I'll see you at the cafe.